Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mihir Joshi. This is the MJ Show. And I have to admit right now that I'm a little embarrassed. I'm a little... it is embarrassing because I actually... This is the first time, it must be, that I had planned an episode at a specific time. And I completely forgot about it. Not because I was doing something else, but because I was listening to the music of the guy who is going to be on my show. I heard his... videos. I had seen it in a whole bunch of places, you know, on Facebook, on Instagram. You must have got somebody sending you one of his songs on WhatsApp or whatever. And I was always very intrigued by the fact that there's a guy who's actually making music using an iPad. The first time I saw it, I was a little taken aback. I was like, what's happening? How am I listening to Carnatic music on an iPad? And how is it sounding so good? And then when I spent a little more time, I heard more of his stuff, I realized that it takes as much or probably even more skill and effort to play music, to play great music on an app on an iPad than it probably does to, you know, just play it on an instrument as well. Okay, let's not equate the two. I'm sure both of them are equally difficult, equally beautiful. What I'm trying to say is that I'm not going to ever dismiss somebody who says that I make music on an iPad and it's because of this gentleman. So ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome on the MJ Show the incredibly talented
and you know, let's get his music up on the screen behind us, because I want to show you guys something that he's done. Hi Mahesh, how are you?
Very good, Mihir. How are you doing?
I am doing really well, man. And like I was telling everyone, this is probably the first time that I've gone, you know, generally when I say 8 o'clock, I'm the one who's ready at 8. I message my guest 5 minutes to 8 and say that, hey, we're going to go live in 5 minutes. And I just sent him a screenshot. I sent him a screenshot of me listening to one of his songs on my phone. I was just so lost. Here's the coolest thing. Literally, while I was listening to it, I was talking to Benny Dayal and to Shefali Alvarez. They've just put out a new song. I was telling Benny, so Benny said that he's, of course, heard your music, and I sent him your cover of Tu Hi Re, and then I told him, check out his Lalishk as well. So I sent your YouTube links on this WhatsApp group that the three of us were chatting on, and we were just talking about how good you really are. And I got so lost in that I literally forgot to see the time, and I realized, oh shit, you messaged me saying, hey, are we live now? And I'm like, are we supposed to be live right now? And then I looked at the time, I'm like, oh man, this is insane. But finally, thank you for your patience, and thank you for joining me today on the MJ Show, man.
Thank you for having me here. Thank you for having me.
Let's go straight into what you are doing, because it's fascinating. It's really, really brilliant what you're doing. I mean, I was saying this in my introduction as well. I had actually encountered your videos many years ago. You know, I mean, since you've been putting them out on YouTube, on Facebook, you know, it keeps popping up. And, you know, the gimmicky videos are obviously a lot, you know, shared a lot more. You know, your versions of songs like Despacito and Game of Thrones and Sherlock and all of these other really cool franchises that you've taken and made them your own. Those are really fun to watch for sure. And I know for everybody watching right now, if you've not seen them, go subscribe to Mahesh's channel on YouTube or follow him on Facebook, and you can check out all of these videos. But what I want to talk about is, how did this concept begin? What made you... I want to know your origin story. How did you get to the point where you decided that this is going to be my instrument of choice?
So, as a kid, I was very fascinated by two things. One was music and the other was technology. As being born in a South Indian family, my extracurricular activity was Carnatic music. So, that's what I did since I was... when I was 3.5, I started learning Carnatic music, and I learned keyboards and all of the Western stuff as well. So by the time I was 16, 17, with the support of my parents, I did a bachelor's in audio engineering. So,
oh, wow. Basically,
and then I went to Scotland to do my master's in music tech. And that's where I sort of did a lot of experimentation. And I discovered this app called GeoSynth. And I still am a huge fan of Jordan Rudess, who is the keyboardist from Dream Theater. And he is one of the developers of the app that I play now, which is called GeoShred. So following his work on all of the applications that he's developed, I started I discovered this app called GeoSynth, and I was very intrigued at the capability of sliding between notes, because being a keyboardist, the only way I could slide between notes was pitch bend.
Pitch bend.
Yeah. So now I have a touch screen. I'm able to slide very freely across a touch screen. So I thought this was really cool. And I thought, okay, why not start a YouTube channel, try and practice Carnatic music on this iPad. And over the years, it sort of became a thing. I didn't know the amount of time I spent on the app. I practiced it like a real instrument. Just time just flew. And 2 years ago, things started moving in a really positive direction. And I decided, okay, time to take this full time. And I moved to India. I live in Bangalore right now. So full time iPad musician.
That's amazing, man. That's fantastic. And I see that you actually have a whole bunch of different projects that you're simultaneously, or, you know, at least you have worked on, because I saw that there is something called the Tayar Sadhan project. Then there is something called, what was the other name? Your Carnatic fusion
Carnatic
project,
yeah.
A Flair, which is your Carnatic music thing. And of course, you've got your own, you perform just by yourself sitting, and you've got some various really interesting collaborators, musicians, singers who are performing with you. So, you know, when you began your journey on YouTube, how easy or how difficult was it for you to get that first song which caught the attention of people? How many videos did it take till you realized, oh, okay, now people are noticing what I'm doing, and, you know, this is really interesting, and I think I should focus and make my production better, make my videos better, because I love what you've done with some of your videos. They're brilliant. Like, I love the Harry Potter one that somebody was just mentioning right now. Mm-hmm. I'm a Star Wars fan. I don't know if you noticed this. By the way, above me are my comic books, and right over there on the other side is my statue collection, and you can see all the Star Wars statues over there. I'm a huge pop culture fan, major nerd, and you know, I've been collecting since I was a kid. So I like what you did, the Star Wars video where you made the iPad come to you through the power of the Force, which was really cool. So, you know, I love what you did with all of your videos as well. But when did you realize that, okay, this is working and I need to focus and make this a better production quality thing?
So initially, obviously, I edited all the videos myself. It was really a true passion project for me, because I love to, you know, experiment with technology, learn how things work. So I learned video editing. I learned, obviously, music was my thing. So music wasn't like, I used to always produce music during my free time. I used to work in radio in Dubai. So in my free time, I used to produce a lot of music, and everything was dedicated to the YouTube channel, and I kept improving and improving and improving, and then people started calling me for live performances when I was still working in Dubai, and most of them were happening in India. And 2 years ago was when I kind of I thought I'll take the Carnatic 2.0 act live. Our first show was in China. It was great, like traveling to China, performing Carnatic music, and then. One thing just led to another. It wasn't really that, okay, it was one video that changed my perception about things. It was just like one thing just led to another. It was an organic journey. That's how it was.
That's awesome, man. So I noticed, looking at your YouTube channel, so let me first show it to everybody. Guys, that is Mahesh's YouTube channel. As you can see, I have already subscribed to it. Make sure you guys go and subscribe as well. And I kept, you know, in terms of the most popular videos, I was looking at it. And your cover of Despacito has done really well, which you put out like some 3 years ago. It's got close to 8 million views right now. And of course, the Harry Potter theme, the Game of Thrones theme. You've done a whole bunch of A.R. Rahman songs. So, you know, let's take one of these songs that you've done, which has really been appreciated by everybody. Like, everybody's watched it, shared it, whether it's on YouTube or Facebook or whatever. And let's break it down a little bit. Choose whichever song you want. Instead of me telling you which song I really love, why don't you tell me a song that you really love from all of these songs that have done really well?
Actually, there's tons to choose. Why don't you just pick one at random and I'll talk
about it. Okay, I'll pick one. So, you know, while it may not be in your top 10 list, the song that kind of kept me away from the phone for such a long time, ironically enough, while I was listening to it on the phone, was Lal Ishq. I thought it was stunning. I absolutely love what you've done with Lal Ishq, because there's so much emotion that you're able to get through the bending of the notes. And this, you know, it almost feels like your iPad is singing the song the way it was sung by Arijit Singh, or, you know, and there is a lot more, adds a lot more tenderness to it, because, you know, it's just the music playing, and, you know, it's not words coming out. So tell me a little bit about how do you approach a song like that, given, you know, okay, this is the song I'm going to be making a video of, a cover of, using the iPad. How do you go about it?
So there are two kinds of productions. One is like a full-blown like, you know, like a music video and everything, like it's a big project. And then there are other projects that I focus on just on musicality. Obviously I don't compromise on musicality on any of my projects, but there are some songs which are extremely musical and the focus is mainly the melody. And Lal Ishq was one of those projects where it's just bare bones. It's just piano, pads and iPad. And on that song especially, so not a lot of people realize that when you play an instrument on the iPad doesn't have force touch. So on the iPhone, when you press hard, like it's pressure sensitive, right? So on the iPad, I don't have that. on that song, I figured out some sort of jugaad to get a lot more dynamics on that song than all my other songs. Dynamic stands out because there's just piano. Okay. Usually I compress the iPad a lot. But on that song, I was able to get soft, loud. So there's a lot more emotion that it can be emoted a lot more with that song. So
brilliant, brilliant.
Yeah.
So, when I heard it, for me, you know, the good, I think a lot of people, when they hear the word cover version, they find it, they're very dismissive about it. For me, I actually believe that creating a cover is not creating a second copy of a song. It is taking your expression as an artist and giving it your own, your artistic thought process behind it. When you impart it to a song, that is a cover. When somebody takes a karaoke track and sings on top of it and it's supposed to sound like the original, that's just a copy. There's a difference between a cover and a copy. Like if you look at the Great American Songbook from, in Western music, those were great songs that are being sung over the generations. Like everybody from Michael Bublé and Rod Stewart to Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin has done covers of like those 50 to 100 songs which were there. And they are still beautiful and they are still fresh because they give it their own taste. You know, if you hear Michael Bublé doing a song which was written by George Gershwin, it's very different from how Fred Astaire would have done that song. Exactly. I think you've done just that with Lal Ishq. You took a song which was somebody else's and you made it your own, where I can say that I can listen to Lal Ishq by Mahesh Raghavan and I can be completely content with it without having to think about who originally sang that song. And that is the greatest compliment that an artist can get, when a cover can stand on its own. I think you've done that, man.
Thank you. So that song was all about, you know, getting the emotion right. And also there's a lot of Carnatic twist in that. There's a lot of variation in the version that I have done, which is a little different from the original. It's like sways here and there. That song was actually really, really special for me. So I just thought, okay, let's just do it.
So, you know, speaking of your Carnatic variations, even on the songs that you do, like Girls Like You, or, you know, your Hotline Bling, or, you know, All of Me, all songs that are taken from Western singers, I always say that as a Western singer myself, we sing in straight lines. You know, maybe R&B guys still have a little more daviness to the way they sing, but mostly it's straight lines. But if you look at Carnatic music or even Hindustani classical music, it's anything but straight lines. It's just beautiful, you know, vibratos and various happen with the melodies, which are very difficult for Western singers to do. And I love that you bring that as well in the Western songs. There are these very typically Carnatic moments, you know, those. What do you call it? I don't know the technical terms for it, but, you know, maybe you can tell us. How do you approach a Western song? Now, we talked about Lal Ishq, which is still in the classical range, I mean, in the classical genre space, even if it's Hindustani classical. But, you know, when you take a song like Girls Like You, a Maroon 5 song, how do you approach that when you're going to be making it?
So, the way I play is very, very inspired by, like, Carnatic stringed instruments, for example, the Veena. Of course, I'm really inspired by Mr. U. Srinivas. So he's one of the greatest Carnatic musicians, but he plays a mandolin, which is not really a Carnatic instrument. So so I've heard these instruments since my childhood, and the way I play is very inspired by that style. And and the app that I play also, GeoShred, is a sort of a stringed instrument. So right. When I started playing, I started emulating the sounds of, you know, the veena, mandolin, sitar. And I used to listen to recordings in slow motion, break them down, and try and play the same thing, and then try it at the actual speed. So it was, so that's the technique I learned. And then after that, whatever I played, that Carnatic style kind of remained.
Lovely.
So, and also the way I listen to melodies, I listen from a very Indian perspective. For example, if I listen to Girls Like You, okay, this raga, this note, that note. So that is my approach to thinking also, from, because since I've been trained in Carnatic music for so long, that is, I look at everything from that perspective. And when you look at things from the perspective of Indian music, there is a lot you can add from the Indian side. Yeah, so for example, a tune like Game of Thrones. So it's a very straight melody, but since I know it's in a particular raga, and I can have the characteristics of that raga included in Game of Thrones, and it will fit in very well.
That's brilliant, man. It's phenomenal, man. Once again, for everybody watching right now, if you're not subscribed to Mahesh Raghavan, you must do that on YouTube. This video will go up on the YouTube channel of the MJ Show. So if you came in late, if you missed out any part that he spoke about, you can go and watch it over there as well. And in the description over there, I'll give you a link to his YouTube channel and some of my favorite videos from his YouTube channel. You can go check them out, watch them, share them with everybody, because this is music that genuinely needs to be shared with absolutely everybody. And I can guarantee that everybody from your parents and grandparents to younger kids will love it. Because what I love about what you've done is you've made Indian classical music accessible to a younger generation while keeping the sanctity of it for an older generation as well. So, you know, somebody who is from a slightly older generation will listen to it and say, oh, wow, this is great stuff. And a younger guy will look at it and maybe listen to the beats that you've got and to the cool vibe that you are able to create with classical instrument, even if it's a violin but used in a classical way, and the way you make it sound is really, really fantastic. Speaking of instruments, why don't you tell everybody, you know, because I was looking at a lot of your videos, there are some really interesting pieces of equipment which you have apart from your iPad. Can you tell me like a big setup that you have when you're performing
a video? Yeah, so my setup is my main things are the iPad and the computer. Of course, on the computer, right, it's all standard music production software. But apart from that, I use a lot of gear from Roli. Roli, they make the C-board, which is a rubber keyboard sort of a thing. And they have that block also that lights up. So I tend to use that a lot to kind of ideate my music, because it's just one block and it connects over Bluetooth with my iPad, and I can play. So that's a really cool instrument, and I have the ability to slide on, and it's very interesting because you're sliding on rubber and making music. So yeah. I find that extremely interesting, and also I work with a lot of finger drumming machine thing. I forgot.
I'm gonna ask you what the little one is called. I mean, I've seen the bigger ones in Ableton setups that, you know, keyboard players have or drummers have. Yeah. But what's the little one that you have with the 16 squares that light up?
The square one, right? Yeah, that's called the light pad block. That is made by Roli.
Oh,
yeah,
that's also made by Roli.
Yeah. So those two are. The light pad block is my favorite thing, because it's just so small, but you can make such a big sound out of it by connecting it to whatever you want. And my latest thing is I do a lot of If you've heard of the machine, the drum that it has the pads, right? So
Right.
I like that a lot too, because it's just a faster way of looking at beat production and all of
Thank
that.
you.
So there are so many things that I keep getting. I'm really passionate about all of these gadgets. So
That's super
yeah,
cool,
thank you.
man. But for a lot of young people, and I can see a lot of people who loved your work, who are your fans, who are with us right now, and for people who watch it later on as well, for younger people who want to get into music production in this way, what's the advice you will give them? How do they get good at electronic music production? Because I can clearly see, like you said, from the age of three almost, you were actually playing real instruments. Is that the
Yeah.
precursor getting good with electronic instruments as well, or can they jump straight in and start off with electronic instruments?
Definitely. So, see the so my the advantage I had first, since I learned the piano for the longest time, I had very good like fingering technique. So, and that relates to the iPad, that relates to the Rode gear also. So I could pretty much relate, and since I knew my way around music theory, it was easy to figure out, okay, this is the fifth, this is the fourth, this is an octave string above. So for me, the learning curve was not so bad when I pick up a new instrument. Even today, when I pick up a new instrument, I can relate with the things that I've already learned. Because
Okay.
the more you know, the faster you learn. That's how it
Right.
is. It is just
Right.
that, like, so if someone is actually looking at getting into full-time music production, I would definitely suggest at least learn the keyboard or
Right.
learn to play the piano. Because when you're producing music, you would want to just, you have this idea in your head, and from that idea in your head to get it to the computer, you need to get it in the fastest way, otherwise the idea will disappear. So
Correct.
when I have the idea in my head, I know exactly what to play and get it on the computer. So that makes it easier for me to produce music.
That's brilliant, man. That's really brilliant. Somebody is just saying here, Ishwar Arun is saying, Al Ayal. Did I pronounce it right?
That's one of the Malayalam songs for Carnatic 2.0.
So, you know, I noticed that, of course, apart from the English songs and the Hindi songs, which vocally I could relate with, or melodically because I knew them, I know you're doing songs. What are the various other language covers that you've done on the channel? Malayalam songs, I saw there were a couple of Tamil songs as well. What are you?
Yeah. So I usually do a lot of, there's of course two things that I do. One is pop culture related, and one is the classical side. In the classical side, it's usually the Carnatic space, and that's not really language dependent, because when you look at the repertoire of Carnatic music, you have Telugu, Kannada, Tamil, and Malayalam. So
Malayalam.
when you learn Carnatic music, you have to be familiar with all these spaces. So the repertoire is basically in either of these languages, and of course Sanskrit as well. So a lot of the stuff that I've done in the Carnatic space is in a South Indian language usually.
Correct.
But other than that, all the original stuff that I do is it's either instrumental, or I did a series called Margari Reloaded last year, which was all Swara and Indian classical bass, but there were a couple of songs that were predominantly in Tamil, because I'm not
Right.
Tamilian.
By the way, you sing as well? Because I saw
Yeah,
Krishna.
I learned Carnatic vocals for the long for
You've
15
learned
years.
Carnatic vocals, because I saw your Krishnani Begane where you were singing well. And why do you not feel the need to sing more often? Because I more often, you know, your work is instrumental, and there's very very little singing that's happening, unless it's a collaborator who's singing along with you.
Yeah, so over the years, I've dabbled my feet in a lot of things. Singing is the thing that I've learned the longest, actually, and that is the skill that actually helped me get Carnatic music on the iPad. Because whatever I play, I have to sing it in my head first, and then figure out. Then that's how I used to translate it into the iPad. But in my live shows for Carnatic 2.0, I just sing all the songs, and it's like 50-50, so that I do a variety of things on stage. But in my productions, usually, like in my first album, most of the songs had my voice in it.
Oh, lovely.
So it's not that I sing less, it's just that I'm not visible singing so much online.
Speaking of your album and your originals, your music is apart from YouTube, is it available on all streaming platforms as well? Forgive my ignorance.
Yeah. Not the
It is.
covers, though. The
No,
covers
not
are
the cover, your original material, your original material.
All on YouTube.
Brilliant.
All
So,
on Spotify and Amazon also. Yeah, sorry. Spotify.
for you guys, apart from following him on YouTube, make sure you also follow him on Spotify or whatever music platform you use, whether it's YouTube Music, Prime Music, or whatever. I'm sure his music is there on all platforms. Go and check that out. I've spent, since the last few days, I've spent a lot of time with his music on YouTube. But now that I know that your originals are on music streaming platforms, I'm also going to be one of you, and I'm going to join all of you in listening to his music on those platforms. I want to talk to you about how this lockdown period has been for you. Was it fruitful from the perspective of creating more music, or was it just frustrating considering you could not really go out and perform, even make music videos you would have wanted to make them because you can't really go out and shoot and
Yeah.
whatnot?
So it's lockdown was pretty interesting for me because when the lockdown started, just before it started, I was actually in the US on a tour.
Okay.
And
Okay.
our last three shows in the US were canceled because of the situation there. And we had to book an emergency flight and come back before the restrictions start. And then lockdown was announced 2 days after we came back, and we were
Oh, wow.
quarantined for the longest time. It was quite an adventure. But so many good things have happened during this time because I've started teaching. I've done a lot of master classes in this time, and I teach at Whistling Woods
Oh, wow.
online.
Okay.
Yeah, so
Online.
I've started teaching a lot, and I've started discovering a lot more music and listening to a lot more music. I'm still always busy. But the great part is I'm eating healthy, I'm sleeping more, I'm doing
That's
exercise.
brilliant, man. That is
So
brilliant.
there's a plus and minus, of course. If you're not able to perform, that's different. But whenever it's safe to perform, we'll go back to that life.
I'm sure. By the way, speaking of your teaching, apart from Whistling Woods, you've also been doing these master classes on Live Demy, right?
Yeah, so I've been doing a lot of things on Live Demy. So, LiveDemy is a great platform to learn music, and I have my next master. So, I am doing master classes. Currently, I'm doing a series of two master classes. The second one happens on September, but I think it's already sold out. But after that,
Oh, brilliant.
I'm recording a course for GeoShred. So, if you want to learn beginners GeoShred, the course will be on LiveDemy. So, I'm working on that right now. That's the next exciting project for me.
That's fantastic. By the way, for all of you who are wondering what Live Demy is, again, when this video goes up on YouTube, I'll give you a link to Live Demy as well. Check it out. They've got, apart from Mahesh, they've got people like Kaushik Chakravarty. They've got a whole bunch of really, really talented singers and artists. Mahesh Kale, who's been on the MJ show, he's going to be doing something over there as well. I believe they've got a lot of really, really cool singers and musicians, Carnatic, Hindustani, all sorts of
Yes.
musicians. Teaching master classes on that, and like he just said, his next class in September is already sold out. But follow them even here on Instagram, and then you'll get to know when their next classes get announced. And you can, if you want to learn from Mahesh or from any of the other people, you can follow, you can figure out how to do it, download the app, and be a part of that thing. Because I think brilliant. One of the things that has happened during the lockdown, not just for artists but even for fans, is the ability to learn something new. We able to take out time to do things that you thought that, "Arey yaar, ye toh abhi time nahi, I don't have time to do this right now." But now is the time. You're still at home, and very frankly, until a vaccine is generated, I don't see things changing drastically. Like, yes, things are opening up, you're going to offices and all that, but you're still going to have a lot of time at home. And this is the right time for you to learn new things, especially music, because as you guys know, entertainment and music has been the one thing that has kept all of you sane in these last 6 months. So get deeper into the music that you love, and you can definitely learn from from him on a live demo. Mahesh, I want to end it off by us talking about what's planned for the future. What are you looking at doing next? When is your next video coming out, or what's your next project going to be?
The next big thing I'm working on definitely is this online course, because that's something I'm extremely excited about, and it's going to be coming. And also, I'm working on a lot of music with all of my collaborators. So it's all different things in the pipeline in parallel. So I'm really excited for that. And also, hopefully, my next album should come out next year. So that's a lot of things happening. But yeah, I keep uploading things like Lalishk. And, you know, all of these covers keep coming, and a lot more originals are in progress as well. So very excited.
So let me say this right away, as I do to all my guests. Whenever you've got your next album coming out, get in touch with me again. We'll get you back. We'll talk about the album specifically. We'll find out about the songs, get deeper into the album, let people, you know, find out a little bit more about the making of it, the stories behind the songs. And this time, I know... we've done it online. Hopefully by the time your album comes out, we'll be able to do it in person or in a slightly better format. And I'd love for you to actually perform something for us live during the show as well. In fact, let me ask you if we can do something right now. Do you have your iPad with you right now?
Of course.
Let's end off today's episode with a performance. What would you like to play for us? What would you like to...
Let me play the song you were just listening to.
That'd be spectacular. Go for it, man.
Awesome. Just give me a moment. Can you hear?
Can the volume be increased a little bit more? Yeah, that's perfect. Oh, yeah.
So, just to explain, it's all square boxes, and there are six lines that represent six strings, and all of the notes represent the notes of the rag or the scale that I'm at right now.
So, it essentially emulates like a guitar. Right?
It's a fretboard.
It's a fretboard. It's a guitar fretboard which you have on your iPad. Right.
Yeah, it's a fretboard that you play with like a keyboard.
Right. Go for it.
Okay. So I'm going to play a couple of lines from Lalishk. Okay. I'm just going to adjust. Okay. Okay. Great. Okay.
Brilliant, man. And I thought that rather than just seeing my face, I let people watch your video of Lal is behind me while you were performing. That was fantastic. By the way, you know what? Now that you've got your iPad out, I can't let you go without doing one of your pop culture type songs as well. You can pick the one that you want. It could be Game of Thrones. It could be Sherlock. It could be Death. You know, any of the songs that you've done.
Okay, sure. One second. Let me have a look at what I can play. Just give me a moment.
Sure. So by the way, for everybody watching right now, while he's figuring that out, make sure you go and subscribe to Mahesh Rajman on YouTube. Hit the bell icon so that you know when he's got a new song out, because he's got some great, great content happening on his YouTube channel. In fact, his version of some of the A.R. Rahman songs that he's done on YouTube as well are absolutely stunning. You should go check them out if you're an A.R. Rahman fan, for sure.
Cool. So I'm gonna play probably a medley of two, and let's see how this goes. Have
Go for it.
a backing track triggered also, so it's gonna be cool.
Spectacular, man. For everybody who's making a ton of requests, here's my request to you. Go right now on YouTube and listen to all your favorite songs by Mahesh Raghavan, because there are so many brilliant ones that I know everybody has their own favorite songs. So go and check them out over there. But for today, this is pretty much all the time we have. Mahesh, thank you so much for chatting
thank
with me,
so
man.
Much.
I really enjoyed getting to know more about you.
Thank you. Same here, man. So nice talking to you.
A message for everybody who's a fan of yours, who's been messaging you, has been giving you a lot of love since we started talking. Just something that you want to tell everybody.
There's the support that I've gotten from people has been overwhelming. And I'd like to thank all of you for just... So all of you are the reason that I keep making music, and there's tons of music coming. So wait for it.
Brilliant. And also, please tell all of your fans to subscribe to the MJ Show as well.
Oh, please subscribe to Mihir. He has some great artists lined up, and I've seen some of the interviews, and I get to learn so much by watching the artists that he interviews. And please subscribe to the MJ Show, Mihir, right now, YouTube, Instagram, follow him everywhere.
Thank you, man. Thank you very, very much. But you know what? Hopefully, once this lockdown is all over, we meet in person and we'll do a more in-depth interview, get deeper into your original music that you're going to be releasing very soon. But congratulations on all the incredible success and love that you are getting from everyone. I genuinely say it with all my heart, it is completely well deserved. I am a fan of your work and your talent. Awesome
Thank
stuff.
You so much. Thank you so much, Mihir.
Take care of yourself. I'll see you soon. Bye.
Thank you. See you. Bye.
That's pretty much all the time we have for now. That is Mahesh. My name is Mihir Joshi. This was the MJ Show, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.